Back to Svartalfheim, huh?
We still have unfinished business there. Those bloody mining rigs in the bay, for one.
Enough, Harry.
Brothers, how did you manage to kill Garm anyway?
We killed him a few times, actually, but it didn't take. And I figured maybe the way to stop a soulless beast was to give it a soul. So I gave it the one I had on me.
I beg your pardon?
Fenrir, remember the light Father saw? The accidental magic I did when Fenrir died? That was part of Fenrir's soul going into my knife. Once I figured that out, I just... Fenrir into Garm.
Clever one, lad! A gigantic hell beast with the soul of a loyal pup. Bloody brilliant!
You know Garm? Why was he locked up to begin with?
Ah, Hell's feral sentinel. Believe it or not, Midgard was once bigger. Until Garm, then just a wee pup, got peckish.
He ate Midgard?
Only a few mountain ranges. And the fifth season that comes after winter but before spring. And a word for the feeling when you get so hungry, you stop being hungry.
You're messing with me.
I would never. Another of Kvasir's poems.
You know that.
Had a worse time of it being locked up. Him or me?
As you said, your prison at least had a view.
Aye. But with a view comes the ability to mark the passage of time, and watching the days pass, one by one. It's not something I'd wish upon anyone. Except maybe Odin himself. Hardly makes sense to backtrack, brothers. Perhaps there's another exit in the room that didn't hold Tia.
Completed some new blueprints. I think you'll find them useful.
Would have been a shame to have left that behind.
Thank you.
I think I see something. Something we should be doing, or are we just exploring?
Thank you.
they capture Garm in the first place?
That was Tyr's doing. He lured the beast somewhere safe and kept it distracted by lending his own arm to be gently chewed. Once the chains were on and the gate to Helheim was opened, Garm bit Tyr's arm clean off in retribution.
But Tyr's not missing an arm.
Well, it grew back, eventually. He is a very resourceful god, after all. Meeting the Lady of the Forge really brought back some memories. I thought it was only in my homeland you'd see such things.
Mermaids who forge weapons.
Aye. I remember very fondly a lieutenant called Mimir. Very talented with a sword.
Mimir.
I meant that literally. Shame on you. You made the best swords in all the Isles and had big dreams about what you'd do with them one day. I wonder what became of it. I recall, I was about to relate the story of the Heath Witches, who overthrew a government using only deceptive prophecies. They picked an influential thane, an otherwise loyal man, and fed him a story of his own ascension to king. They dressed it up in enough details they knew would come to pass, so when they did, the thane took it as confirmation.
Another time. We must focus.
Turning to my anecdote about the Heath Witches, they fed the Thane a prophecy of his ascension to king. Next thing you know, he's helping matters along. He murders his king, sleeping under his own roof. Murders many he once called friends, too, thinking them fated to oppose him. Then, for a finishing touch, the witches revisit this usurper. With just a few details structured ever so misleadingly, they convinced the fool he was invulnerable to all threats.
Physical or magical.
Aye, aye. But 'twas not so for him. Ah, but enough of that for now.
I think there's another realm to bomb me to.
Deeper!
Mimir, if I met someone I liked, how would I know if they, liked me too?
Is there someone?
No. I was just curious. Actually, doesn't matter. Doesn't matter.
Is Thrud who you meant when you asked about liking?
Thrud? No. I mean, I wasn't asking about anyone specific. And, well, Skjöldr likes Thrud. But she's only interested in becoming a Valkyrie. She's focused, you know?
Well, very well, lad. Very well. Just hope you know if you ever need to review anything we've discussed.
I know. It's good. I'm fine.
To wrap up that story I was telling, the usurping Thane was convinced by the Heath Witches of his own invulnerability. Falsely, as he would learn too late. All turned into a rather magnificent bloodbath as they go. The Thane ends up without his head and a name so cursed, none dare speak it. All thanks to a subtly deceptive prophecy.
You really gotta write these stories down one day, Mimir.
Well, I try. Jaw tends to get sore, but thank you, lad.
Mimir, when I was in Asgard, I saw Odin do something to some new Einherjar. He seemed kind of mindless until he cast a spell that restored their identity.
Aye, that was his habit, even when they were confined to Valhalla. I think letting them remember themselves was another small way of cheating death any way he could. Though I wouldn't be surprised if with that small gift of autonomy, he also embeds an undying personal loyalty to himself.